Da ganze Nacht weimen zu nehmen in it verschämen weimen zu nehmen in it verschämen Tumbala, Tumbala, Tumbala Laika Tumbala, Tumbala, Tumbala la. Spiel Bala Laika Tumbala Laika Spiel Bala Laika Tumbala la.
Thank you. More and more, the ideas that generate organizations are political. Ideological competition is fierce. In the growing Jewish working class, socialism, in all its varieties, gains more and more support. It combines with different national visions. There are Torah socialists. There are Zionist socialists. There are communists. There are Bundists. The Bund is an anti-Zionist labor party that combines an affirmation of the Jewish diaspora with a socialist program.
Ideologically, I became a socialist when I turned 18. And after the first revolution, I decided that one cannot become politically active individually or in small groups. To become politically active, one must become a member of the party. When I joined the Bund, it was a revolutionary party. I met HENDRIX in the Bundist student group at the university.
This student group at the university in St. Petersburg at the turn of the century, like other small groups of activists in East European universities, is, 20 years later, part of the leadership of a mass movement in Poland.
I came to Poland at the end of 1918. Poland, at the moment of gaining its independence, and after the First World War,
tells me you're a great hunter.
Well, you could hardly expect me to enter your office leading a pack of hounds.
Please. I understand you don't like to talk about your health.
That's right.
Any particular reason why?
It's just a boring subject, that's all.
Oh, most people love it. I make my living by listening to them.
Then I'm afraid you're wasting your time.
I'll send you a bill.
I'm 23 years old. An only child. I weigh 110 pounds stripped. I've had measles, mumps, and whooping cough all at the proper ages. I believe I have no congenital weaknesses. Shall I go on?
Yes, please.
My father drank himself to death. My mother lives in Paris. I take a great deal of exercise. I'm accustomed to a reasonable quantity of tobacco and alcohol. I'm said to have a sense of humor. Is that enough?
All the inconsequential facts.
Thank you. What are the consequential ones?
Does that light bother you?
Not at all.
Do you use your eyes a great deal?
I generally keep them open, Doctor.
What do you do with yourself down there in Long Island?
Oh, horses, dogs, shooting, yachting. Travel, parties, gossip. All the pleasures of the station wagon crowd. You don't think much of that, do you?
No, not much.
Why not?
Just doesn't appeal to me, that's all.
Do you condemn everything that doesn't appeal to you?
Oh, by no means. You asked for my opinion, I gave it.
Well, anyway, that's my racket. What's yours?
Mine? No. Brain surgery, large practice, about 10 days off every summer.
Sounds awful.
It is.
Then why do you do it?
Because, like yourself, I've been caught in a racket.
Oh, Doctor, what a relief to know that you're no better than I am.
Thanks. Ah, but you see, I'm clearing out of my racket. I'm leaving for Vermont in about 15 minutes.
Vermont? You don't mean that narrow, pinched-up little state on the wrong side of Boston?
That's the one.
No kidding?
No kidding.
What are you going to do there between yawns?
You wouldn't be interested.
Oh, come now, Doctor, after leading me on like this.
Well, I'm going to do scientific research on the growth of cells.
In little guinea pigs?
No, just cells.
Sounds silly.
So I'm told.
Still, I almost envy you. Must be nice to believe in what you're doing.
Don't you?
Not in the way you do. Oh, I'm not complaining. Take it all in all, they've dealt me a very good hand. I'm young, I have no particular responsibilities. I don't intend to cultivate any either. One's freer without. I shall probably marry someday, no hurry about that. When I do, I shall build a house on a ridge I know with a glorious view. I have my horses. Any luck, I'll have about 40 years of that. I think that's a pretty good setup.